Imagine a world in which, if you lose a limb, it grows back as if nothing happened. In addition to changing the plots to a few of our favorite movies, our whole outlook on injury and amputation would be completely different. For some creatures, this isn't science fiction, but something as common and straightforward as growing back a trimmed fingernail. This is Limb Regeneration. Hey, I'm Tasha, and you're watching Animalogic. Today we're talking about creatures with incredible powers of regeneration. If these superheroes lose a limb, spinal cord, tail, or even damage their vital organs, they can return to their uninjured state without so much as a scar to show for it. Most famous of the regenerators is the adorable Axolotl. Ambystoma mexicanum, this sassy little salamander, is up there with pygmy hippos and quokkas as the internet's most beloved cuties. That's because Axolotls are neotenic, which means they keep their juvenile features into adulthood. They basically look like puppies forever. But even more than for their adorable looks, Axolotls are widely known as being the most regenerative species on Earth. Because of these superpowers, hundreds of thousands of Axolotls are studied in labs around the world. That's despite being almost entirely extinct in the wild. Their original habitat was limited to two single lakes in the southern Mexico City neighborhood of Xochimilco, where wild specimens are rarely seen. All amphibians show some degree of regrowth, but not every species can regenerate. Salamanders are the top regenerators of the amphibians and can recreate tissues, organs, parts of their nervous system, or even entire body parts throughout their lives. Axolotls are the cream of the salamander regenerator crop, being able to regenerate most of their tissues and organs throughout their lives, even parts of their brain. They're so regenerative that they can even accept transplanted organs and limbs from other individuals. So what happens when a salamander's limb is severed? Just like in most other species, first the wound heals over. For humans and other non-limb regenerating creatures, this is where the story ends with a big scar. But for regenerating amphibians, the journey continues. There are two main phases for limb regrowth. In the first phase, and within a few hours of amputation, the wound epidermis at the stump end forms and starts sending chemical signals to the cells below. In response, cells from the surrounding tissues rush toward the wound area, forming what's called a blastema. These cells come from the muscle and tissue in the stump, which have reverted back to their earlier state, making them so-called progenitor cells. Progenitor cells are descendants of stem cells, which have the ability to self-renew and turn into many different types of cells. Since progenitor cells come from stem cells, they share some qualities. But progenitor cells can't infinitely renew like stem cells can, and are also more specialized. A progenitor cell in a limb is going to turn into a cell that existed in that limb and won't turn into, for example, an eyeball like a stem cell could. Now that the blastema is formed, the second phase begins, called blastema-mediated redevelopment, a fancy way of saying the actual regrowing part. The blastema keeps expanding and grows outwards in a cone shape. Now the progenitor cells within the blastema can start specializing. They'll continue to grow the limb until it's an exact replica of the original, with the same function, anatomy, and size. Salamanders aren't the only creatures capable of regeneration. Planarians, otherwise known as flatworms, are also super regenerators. In weeks, or as little as days, flatworms are able to regrow heads, tails, and even entire organisms from small body fragments. Similar to salamanders, the new tissue grows out of a blastema. If the body fragment that's regenerating doesn't have the parts the flatworm needs to eat, it has to use whatever resources the fragment contains to regenerate. This means that the flatworm can't always grow back to its original size. Some species of starfish, like the Pacific bloodstar, crown of thorns starfish, and ochre sea star, have the ability to regenerate lost limbs. Even a single limb can regrow the entire star if some of the central disc is still attached. That's because each arm contains parts of the star's vital organs. Much like sea stars themselves, regeneration is a slow process, taking upwards of a year to return to their original shape. Starfish often lose their limbs due to predation, but they can also detach their limbs at will in a process known as autonomy, usually for self-defense. Dropping a limb to provide an easy snack for a predator is certainly preferable to being gobbled up whole. Many species of lizards, like the green anole and leopard gecko, can also drop their tails to evade predators. After it's dropped, the tail even continues to wiggle, providing the perfect distraction for the lizard to make a quick escape. Unlike Axolotl, which can regenerate a perfect replica of their lost appendage, the regenerated tails of lizards are made of cartilage instead of bone. the common blue-tongued lizard's tail even grows back shorter than it was before. Some crustaceans, like Parhyale hawaiiensis, are also able to regenerate an amputated leg within a couple of weeks. The initial replacement leg is smaller than the others, but with each subsequent molt, the leg becomes more and more indistinguishable from the original. Adult zebrafish are also able to regenerate many of the tissue in their bodies, including all fins, the retina, spinal cord, heart, and kidneys. While fins are regenerated from a blastema, like in salamanders, other organs in the zebrafish rely on different processes to repair themselves. The hearts of zebrafish are the most regenerative of any vertebrate. Up to 20% of the ventricle can be regrown without the formation of scar tissue. The number one killer of human beings is heart disease, which is essentially just scarring of the heart. Scar tissue in the heart prevents short-term damage, but its stiffness limits the heart's overall function, eventually leading to failure. So knowing all that, we gotta ask, why can't humans regenerate like these super creatures? One answer may be that it's not that humans can't regenerate, it's that our bodies form scar tissue when we're injured before we can regenerate. Recent research has shown that introducing macrophages, a type of white blood cell that contributes to scarring, to axolotls in cardiac arrest, caused them to develop scars in their hearts and completely blocked regeneration. Scientists are currently in the process of determining what would happen if, like axolotls, we didn't have these scar-forming cells stepping in when our limbs are amputated. Furthermore, just because humans can't regenerate limbs doesn't mean that this ability isn't locked away somewhere in our genetic code. Salamanders and humans share a common ancestor that lived around 330 million years ago, right around the time when the fish-like creatures of the age began growing limbs and taking their first steps on land. There's still a long way to go in our research about our own regenerative powers and what could be possible in the future. In addition to regeneration, axolotls are also 1,000 times more resistant to cancer than mammals. That's why studying these super regenerators is so critical for medical advancements. Who knows what diseases and ailments we might cure in the future once we solve the mysteries of regeneration. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe for new videos every week. Bye. If you like this video, check out our video on autotomy, which is when animals purposely cut off their limbs.
Hey everyone, we have exciting news. We're thrilled to announce the release of Animalogic's very first book, Strange Creatures. This book dives into the most incredible animals we've ever featured on the show, with each chapter packed with my illustrations and stunning full-color images. It's a fun and engaging way to learn about the animal kingdom, and a perfect tool to spark kids' interest in science. Each chapter breaks down an animal's biology, behavior, and all the coolest facts you need to know about these fascinating creatures. Animalogic's Strange Creatures is a must-have addition to your own library, or the perfect gift for an animal lover this upcoming holiday season. Click the link in the description to check it out, and if you can, pre-order a copy. Pre-ordering would help us get an extra bump in the Amazon algorithm, and that would mean the world to us. So thank you so much.